about the statement of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as mentioned in the hadith of Abi Yahya, Suhayb ibn Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "I'm mu'min. I'm amazed at the situation of a believer. The situation of a believer is always good, and that's only for a believer." And so, even in this Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distinguished us in the midst of this pandemic. The believer is distinguished all the time. He's distinguished, and a part of that distinction that Allah has made for the believer is the distinction of happiness. The distinction of happiness. Allah mentions in Surah Hud, يَوْمَ يَتِي, yani on the day of judgment, يَوْمَ يَتِي لَا تَكَلَّمُ نَفْسٌ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ فَمِنْهُمْ شَقِيٌّ وَسَعِيدٌ. On that day when it is established, no one will speak except with Allah's permission. And some of them will be miserable, and some of them will be happy. And those who will be happy on that day, their happiness began in this dunya. And so you be happy. You be happy because Allah has described you as being happy. Be happy because the Prophet ﷺ described you on this day as being happy. As mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, لِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ, the one who fasts, he has two moments of being happy. فَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ فِتْرِهِ وَفَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ, that he's happy when he breaks his fast. We have broken our fast. There are things that were made forbidden for us during the daytime that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made permissible for us again. There's a natural happiness that comes with that. And there's the other happiness that comes with having completed this worship of Allah. And the fact that we completed this worship under such challenging circumstances, it's a cause to be happy. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahil hamd. And from the reasons to be happy, subhanAllah, look at how Allah guides the believers to happiness. From the reasons of being happy is that we could not have iftar in the masjids. We could not have iftar in the masjids. And so because of that, we tried to use those resources, the resources of money and food, and allocate them elsewhere. And so because of that, programs were developed to reach those people who need food, to take hot meals to people who would otherwise not be able to get meals during Ramadan. And this is a cause. This is a cause in the book of Allah to be happy. وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. And they feed others in spite of their own love for food. They feed the poor, and they feed the orphans, and they feed the captives. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ, we only feed you for the cause of Allah. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا, we don't want any reward from you, and we don't want any thanks. إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا, we fear a horrible, distressing day in front of our Lord. And so what does Allah say? فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ, and so Allah saved them from the distress of that day. وَلَقَّاهُمْ نَضْرَةً وَسُرُورًا, and he replaced their fear, because they fed others, with radiance on the outside, and with surur, with happiness on the inside. So be happy. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahil hamd. Perhaps we feel sad because for many of us, we could not pray behind our imams. And so we prayed at home, and we had so little of the Quran, and it was difficult for us to read. But that's a cause to be happy. Because as mentioned in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, collected in Bukhari and Muslim, she says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنَ وَهُوَ حَافِظٌ لَهُ مَعَ السَّفَرَةِ الْكِرَامِ الْبَرَّةِ, the likeness of the one who reads the Quran and he has memorized it, then he is like the angels. Allahu Akbar. He is like the angels who carry the revelation, who have been honored to carry the revelation, and who are obedient to Allah because of what they have of the Quran. But he hasn't left out the believers. He says, وَمَثَلُ الَّذِي يَقْرَى الْقُرْآنَ وَهُوَ يَتَعَاهَدُهُ وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَدِيدٌ فَلَهُ أَجْرَانٌ, and the one who reads the Quran, but he has to keep reviewing it because he hasn't memorized it, and it's difficult for him to read, and it's difficult for him to recite. Allah has promised him two reward for that difficulty. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Wallahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Perhaps because of this pandemic, because we could not work, because we could not go to work, because we could not be in public places, wasting our time as we normally would. We were stuck at home, and so we were reading the Quran more. We were reading the Quran more, reading Allah's book, reflecting on it and pondering on it. And this is the ultimate reason to be happy, as Allah mentions in His book. Ya ayyuha an-nas, qad ja'atkum maw'izatun min rabbikum. Mankind, there has come to you a counsel and an admonishment from your Lord. Wa shifa'un lima fis sudur, and a healing for what is in the chest. Wa hudan wa rahmatun lil mu'minin, and a guidance and a mercy for the believers. Qul bi fadlillahi wa bi rahmati, say with Allah's blessing and His mercy. Fa bi dhalika falyafrahu, let them be happy about that. Let them celebrate that. هُوَ خَيْرُ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ, it is greater than anything that the kuffar amass of this dunya. The scholars of tafsir mention, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِي, that Allah's blessing and His mercy, as mentioned in this ayat. The scholars of tafsir of the past, from the Sahaba and from the Tabi'een, they said that what's meant here is Al-Qur'an وَأَنْجَعَلَ لَكُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ أَهْلِهِ. He said the virtue of Allah and His mercy in this ayat, it refers to the Qur'an and the fact that Allah made you from the people of the Qur'an. Other scholars of tafsir mentioned, هو القرآن والإسلام, it is the fact that Allah has blessed us with the Qur'an and that He has made us Muslim. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Wallahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. From the reasons to be happy is that Allah in this pandemic has brought many Muslim households back to life. Because these households, when they are not worshipped in there, when there is no worship established in these households, they become like graves. As mentioned in the hadith of Ibn Umar, collected in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, اجعلوا في بيوتكم من صلاتكم ولا تتخذوها قبورا. Pray some of your prayers at home, yani the non-obligatory prayers. Pray some prayers at home and do not make your homes like graves. When we do not remember Allah at home, our houses become like graves, and the people in these houses, in our houses, our families, they become like the dead. As mentioned in the hadith of Abi Musa al-Ash'ari, collected in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-bayt alladhi mithl al-bayt alladhi yuzkaru Allahu fi wal-bayt alladhi la yuzkaru Allahu fi ka mithl al-hayy wal-mayyit." The difference between the house where Allah is mentioned and the house where Allah is not mentioned or remembered is like the difference between the living and the dead. And so the fact that Allah has brought our houses back to life is a cause for celebration. Not only that, but Allah mentions in His book again that from the joy of the believer, from the reasons that make him happy, is to see his family. It's to see his family worshiping Allah. And wallahi, we have seen the worship of Allah in our households because of this pandemic, because of Allah's goodness and His mercy and what He has decreed. We have seen it in a way that perhaps we have not seen it in a long time. Allah mentions in Surah Al-Furqan that His slaves, Ibad al-Rahman, وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا, that they say, the Ibad al-Rahman, they say, our Lord, make our wives and our children the joy of our eyes and make us leaders in righteousness. Mujahid said that the meaning of make them the joy of our eyes, اجعلهم صالحين أتقياء, make them righteous and God-fearing. Ibn Abbas, he mentioned regarding this ayat, لَيْسَ الْمَقْصُودُ مِنْ هَذَا الدُّعَاءِ الصَّبَاحَةَ وَالْجَمَالِ, that it's not intended by this ayat, radiance and beauty. That's not what they mean by making our family the joy of our eyes. They mean, let us see them worship and be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In spite of this pandemic, look at how much goodness Allah has guided us to. Muslims, we have all cause to be happy and celebrate. So let that happiness be seen on your face. Let it be heard in your voices. Let it resonate and echo throughout our homes. Allahu Akbar Kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر والله أكبر ولله الحمد. Brothers and sisters in Islam, at the end of the first khutbah, I gave you a similitude. The similitude given to us by our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is that these homes can become like graves. When Allah is not mentioned there, and when the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not established, there's also a lesson I want us to take away from this Ramadan. And it also has something to do with the graves, but it's from a different angle. And that is that for many of us, this Ramadan should be a reminder of what our graves will be like. How is it similar? Because when Ramadan began and the masjids were closed, we went in our homes and the only thing we had of worship was what you already took with you. That's how the grave is. You can't increase in worship once you're in your grave. You only take the righteous deeds that you already have with you. When you went in your home for Ramadan, and there was no imam to lead you in your masjid, there was no one else in the masjid to encourage you, you were left to yourself. You were left to the Quran that you had memorized. You were left to the Islam that you had learned and studied and practiced. You were left with the Arabic that you had studied and learned. That's all you had. And there was no opportunity to increase. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we were able to see ourselves and where we're at. We were able to see how much attention or how much negligence we had with the Quran. How much attention or negligence that we gave to Islam. How much attention or negligence we gave to the Arabic language. Brothers and sisters, we have to work to be different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a huge opportunity at this point in time in this city. The Arabic language and the study of the Quran and the study of Islam has been made accessible in a way it perhaps has not been in a very long time. And like Ramadan, it's an opportunity that when it leaves, it goes away. And you might not see it again. And so we cannot be satisfied. We cannot be satisfied in our Islam as we are right now. We cannot be satisfied reaching another Ramadan and we don't understand Arabic and we're not working towards that purpose. We cannot be satisfied and we don't have a hafiz of the Quran in our family. It's a shame. Our Quran competitions have to go beyond Juz'Amma. It's a shame. We have to work to be better. Parents, you, it begins with you. You dedicate yourself that you are not going to be satisfied with only knowing the last 10 surahs of the Quran, that you're going to work from today to memorize the Quran. It doesn't matter if you don't get there before you die. وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ يُدْرِكُهُ الْمَوْتُ فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Whoever leaves his home immigrating for Allah and His Messenger and death finds him along the way and he never makes it, his reward is with Allah. You set out on that path and if you never make it, your reward is with Allah. And don't be satisfied with your children experiencing Islam as you have. Don't be satisfied with them being illiterate when it comes to the Arabic language. Don't be satisfied with your children standing behind the imam 20 years from now and they don't know what he's saying and they don't know the ayat. Don't let your children leave this dunya. Don't you leave this dunya and you haven't experienced the best that it has to offer. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ. Say Allah's blessing and His mercy. Say the Qur'an and being from its people. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَهُ. Let them be happy about that. Let them celebrate that. Let them be excited about that. هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. It's better than anything in this dunya. It's better than all the wealth that people amass. Brothers and sisters in Islam, they say about COVID-19, our disease, the disease of the hour. They say about COVID-19 and they say about the world, there's no going back to normal. Absolutely, positively. Let that be our slogan. We're not going back to normal. We're not going back to a normal where we don't understand the Quran. We're not going back to a normal where we don't have hafal. We don't go back to a normal where we're satisfied with ignorance in Islam. We're going to establish Islam in our households. We're going to work on becoming literate in Arabic, understanding it and speaking it and reading it. We're going to change our new normals that we're going to have hufaz in our family. that the Quran is going to be passed down in our families, generation after generation after generation. This is our new normal, and this is what we're going to establish. Eidukum Mubarak. Allah yatakabbalu minna wa minkum salih al-a'mal. Allahu Akbar kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam taslimin kathira.
Assalamu alaikum.